Hi, Tracy the Sleep Coach here, and I'm here to help you sort out your insomnia. In this episode, I want to talk to you about the phenomenon that myself and many other people that I know, many people with insomnia have experienced, and that is you feel very, very sleepy late in the evening. Perhaps you've stayed up to try to increase your sleepiness a little bit. You get into bed, and suddenly, as soon as your head hits the pillow, you are wide awake. Now, I know that frustration myself. And you might be wondering what causes this, because it can be incredibly frustrating to finally start to feel sleepy, only to have that thwarted by getting into the place where you are supposed to sleep. The main reason this particular response begins to develop happens over time. So before we develop insomnia, we have a relationship with our bed that is very subconscious. We don't even think about it. When we get sleepy, we go to bed and that is where we sleep. We're not doing anything on purpose to create a relationship between sleepy feelings and the bed. It simply happens as a result of what we do when we feel sleepy. After insomnia has set in, however, we often spend a lot of time in bed trying to sleep, feeling very frustrated, worrying about the next day, worrying about the consequences of sleep, becoming physically uncomfortable from tossing and turning all night. We very unconsciously begin to associate our bed not with sleepiness, but with the struggle of trying to sleep. Now, it takes time for this association to develop, but in the end, the way it manifests very frequently for people is that they will feel very sleepy in the evening, they will go up to bed, put their head on the pillow, and suddenly be wide awake. And that is because their body and mind have inadvertently become trained to associate the bed with all of those negative feelings and all of that wakeful energy. Now, that's certainly not to say that it's anybody's fault. These associations happen completely unconsciously. But what we can do is we can use what we know about cognitive behavioral therapy for insomnia and similar types of approaches to reverse engineer the situation so that our relationship with our bed becomes much more positive. I'm a huge fan of mindfulness and acceptance and commitment therapies in working with sleep issues, along with some of the behavioral and cognitive approaches within CBTI. Developing a more positive relationship with our bed is key to overcoming this very weird phenomenon where we are starting out very sleepy and feeling like we're about to drop off, and then we suddenly wake up. In another episode, I will explain to you some of the approaches that I use and a lot of other therapists use with great success that can really be helpful if this is something that you recognize in yourself. Now, if you found this interesting, please share it with a friend, like this video, hit the notifications bell, and subscribe. And I would love to hear if you have any comments or questions, just please drop them below. I will reply to all of the comments that come in. And if you ask a question, it's very likely that you will see it come up in the questions playlist on this channel.